Mortex here, and I just want to say a massive thank you to everyone that subbed on the last video and commented. You guys are amazing. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to put games onto the Retroid Pocket 2. So what you need to do, guys, you need to put the SD card into an SD card reader. And then once you've done that, go onto the PC and go into File Explorer and then find whichever one it's classed as. Mine's classed as a USB drive F. So now you click onto this, let's open it up. Click on to it, and we've got a couple of things. We've got games, we've got RetroArch, wallpaper, and ROMs. So people think you actually install the games on here. This is the external card where they store all their games, but we're not going to bother about that. We want to go to ROMs. So we open the ROMs, and here are all the files. So let's minimize it and get my ROMs up. So I've got my ROM folder here. As you can see, let's just put them side by side. So I've got my SNES ROMs. These are all backed up games. So if we go into SNES and then go into here, let's just drag and drop Aladdin in. So easy as that, copy it over, do that to all the ROMs you've got on the system. As I say, as many ROMs as you've got, put them into the correct folders. And now we will hop back on to the Retroid Pocket 2 and I'll show you how to access them on there. So we've got the Retroid Pocket 2 up and running now. We've got the Dolphin background as normal. So if you want to access the internal memory via the USB Type-C, first you need to obviously plug it into the PC and then plug it into this. You'll hear a little noise, that means it's connected to the PC. And now what we want to do now, we want to get the little mouse pointer up, so we'll do that now. And then we want to go up and we want to press A. And then we want to hover over USB debugging and then let go. Once we've hovered over it, then we want to go down to USB charging. And we want to go over to file transfer. So this will let us transfer files onto the internal SD card. Now for me, as I've mentioned before, I don't like doing it this way. For some reason, it doesn't bring the actual external SD card up. If you want to put anything onto the external SD card, you can't actually do it via the USB Type-C. I've not found a way how to do it at the minute. It will only access the internals. So if you want to put games onto the Retroid Pocket 2 via your external SD card, you are going to have to use one of these for the time being. So once you've got this, we don't need this anymore, we can unplug it. And what I'm going to show you now is how to access the external SD card where you already put all the games on. So we go down, we click onto RetroArch, so let's get this opened. Now the next thing we do, I'm just going to go back to show you all. So we go on to, we've got it here, we go on to load content and then we press start directory. And then we go down to where we've actually installed it. So we've installed it on the SNES folder. So we open that, click it and watch the magic. So there you go, guys, that's easy as pie, that's how you do it. A little bit more difficult than the RG350 to do it, just because the USB Type-C doesn't actually pick up the external card in the device. I'm not sure why, maybe this will get upgraded when we get the Android 8 onto the system, but I'm just not sure why. I mean, the community has been asking about this and I don't think anyone's been able to do it at the minute, but if anyone can, and can show me, that'd be absolutely amazing. But guys, that is how you install games onto the Retroid Pocket 2. Bit of a pain, it's not as easy as plug and play, as I say, but that's one of the ways that you can actually do it. So now if you've got a bigger SD card and you want to have all the files that you've got on the original external SD card, basically it's pretty simple. All you have to do is drag and drop them onto the desktop and then put them onto the new SD card. Now alternatively, if you're not bothered about the pre-installed games, because it does take quite a bit of space up and you don't want these on, I think it takes roughly around 26 gig. If you don't want them on, all I'd recommend is highlighting these five folders, dragging and dropping them onto the new SD card. Then you go and then you can just put it on the new SD card and then you can install your own games on the ROM section here. So you can include all your own games that you want to do. As I say, if you just got a bigger SD card and you want to have the full ROMs on it as well, just drag and drop all these files onto the new SD card and then you'll still have plenty of space. Me personally, I like to hot swap, so I like to hot swap the SD card. So for me, I just do a fresh install of an SD card. I do drag the RetroArch file over with all the ROMs on so I can add my own into it, but that's about it. I don't really install it into the internal, so I don't make the internal memory bigger with the SD card, which you can do, and I'll show you that video right on the screen now. I just prefer to hot swap, so then I can use the SD card in other devices. But there is a couple of choices for you there, so it just depends which one you'd like to pick and use and which suits your suitability the best. So there you have it, that's how you put games onto the Retroid Pocket 2. Not as easy as doing it on the RG350, but we got there in the end. Now don't worry if you haven't got any of these devices at all, but you have got an Android phone and you do want to run some emulation. I have actually got a video down below now that shows you how to run the N64 emulation, and I will be doing a lot more of this on the channel. As always guys, please like, rate and subscribe so you get all the up-to-date latest content, and don't forget to hit that bell notification. But until next time, I'll see you all soon.